Hello, welders. Today, we're going to be talking about how to teach a more complex weldment with the ESAB Cobot. I've gotten a couple questions about the Cobot's abilities to move in 3D space, right? So on something that's in the X plane, the Y plane, and the Z plane. In the past videos for the linear weld, the radial weld, the stitch weld, and the tack weld, we've mainly just done some like horizontal T-joints or the very surface of a pipe, right? But what we're gonna do today is I have a mock-up of a pipe T, and we are going to go ahead and teach a section of that, and you will see how easy and simple it is to use even on a more complex weldment. So I'm gonna start in my app by making a new part, and to do that I press the blue icon in the bottom right corner. I can go ahead and name my part, then click Next. Under the settings library, I'm going to just select my settings. And now I'm in the Teach menu. So what I'm going to do is for a pipe weldment, I'm going to select Radial Weld. And now I am ready to teach some points. So let's go ahead and get you guys in the first person view and you'll be able to see what I'm doing. Now that I have my program set to radial weld mode, I can go ahead and by pressing and holding the green free drive button, I can move my arm out past the weldment and I will press and hold the blue button to switch from weld mode to air move mode. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set an air move out here. And that's just so we can avoid this vertical piece on the way to our weld start, right? So then once that air move is set, I'm going to press and hold the blue button again. And that's gonna let me switch back to weld mode. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna press and hold the green button. And I'm getting my torch angles right. And then I'm clicking the blue button to set a weld point. Now, when you're doing these more complex welds, especially on something like this, you wanna set a point to account for every movement on the horizontal and vertical plane, right? So you're gonna see me come out here and I'm curving on the horizontal plane, so I'm setting one here, and now I'm moving down vertically, so I'm setting a point here, okay, and then I'm going to be moving down again, I'm going to set one here, and then finally, I'm going to come out there. And then I'm pressing and holding the blue button, bringing an air move out above the part, clicking that blue button to set those points, and then I'm going to save my program. And I'm going to create a new playlist with the part. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 welds to program that curve there. Now that our program has been taught and saved, let's see how that turned out. My program is in my playlist, and now I'm going to press play on the operator panel. Welders, as you can see, even a more complex weldment is very simple and easy to program with the power of the ESAB Cobot. Thank you so much for watching, have a great day, and remember, keep it simple, Cobot.